many people who claim to be medical professionals say that, quote, women will die without the ability to kill their own children. Thankfully, some doctors can see through the hypocrisy of such a claim. One of them is Dr. John Bruchalski, who sat down with me when his new book launched to discuss his journey from abortionist to head of one of the leading pro-life conglomerates, the Tepeyac Center. The Tepeyac Center is just one of the thousands of life-affirming care centers that have continued to flourish in this post-Roe world.
All right, we are here with Dr. John Bruchalski of the Tepeyac Center. He is the author of the new book, Two Patients, My Conversion from Abortion to Life-Affirming Care. Dr. John, thanks for joining me this morning.
Oh, Prudence, it is a blessing to be here with you.
Well, it's a blessing to have you here. And you began your book, congratulations on your new book, by the way. You began it really by talking about a medical misjudgment that happened in the delivery room and sort of spurred your conversion. Would you share what happened with us in that moment?
Sure. The misjudgment was taking a good history and physical that all doctors should do. This was absolute, palpable cognitive dissonance. I was a second-year resident in a OBGYN training program, so we learned to do abortions at all times for whatever reasons. I wanted to be the best I could be, and so that's where I was during the daytime. However, as God is always a funny guy, he had me working at a pregnancy center at night, evangelical, First Assembly of God. And we were praying to show people that there was an option other than abortion. So can you imagine? That was unbelievable. And then in labor and delivery that night, in one room, the mom wanted the baby. So I took a good history and did everything I could to keep the baby inside alive. But in the next room, because the mom didn't want it, I didn't take a good history because it wasn't wanted. I broke the water, gave her medicine to deliver her baby. I delivered the baby. It looked a little big. I either could have suffocated it because it was born alive, or I threw it on the scale, and I did toss it. It was over 500 grams, and I had to call in the neonatal intensive care doctors. So here I am, split between life and death, being the best doctor I could be. I didn't take a good history. The baby was farther along. And in walked the neonatal doctor and said, "Why are you treating my patients as tumors? Come to me tomorrow, have some coffee, because you're better than this." And that's what started it. It was the facts of OBGYN wanting to have abortion as part of good health care. But then someone stopped me in my tracks and confronted me. That's that moment that I had to respond to.
And Dr. John, praise God that that conversion began in that moment. But talk to me about how the scar of abortion has impacted your life.
So the scar of abortion is now a scar. It's not a wound anymore because of Jesus' mercy. So once again, I grew up in a great Catholic family. We said the rosary every morning. But I was a man pleaser. I wasn't a God-fearer. I wanted to get along, status quo, be friends. Everything's okay. God's love, it's mercy, relativism, scientism. Don't worry about that, John. There's many ways to God. God understands. He's merciful. There was no mention of justice. And yet, as you do more and more abortions, and you have to count body parts, and then you start killing sick children in the wombs of their mother, Prudence, the pain, the hardness of heart, the sharpness, it's the opposite of being an excellent doctor. Yeah. And for 50 years now, we've had abortion on demand as the foundation of excellent health care.
And now you use your talents as an OBGYN at the Tepeyac Center, which you run. It's a pro-life center where you offer from start to finish everything that a mother needs, an expecting mother. Talk to me about the services you provide there.
So we put the name Tepeyac in it against all marketing odds, because Tepeyac is hard to spell. Nobody knows what it's the hill on which Our Lady appeared to Juan Diego, right?
Yes.
I put it in there because the pressures in medicine and the pressures in life are to go woke and broke spiritually. We don't believe that murdering and killing life or always pitting mom against the baby. Oh, we got to kill the baby to save you. Wrong answer. We've been treating miscarriages and ectopics and all the conditions of OBGYN for about 28 to 29 years without having to resort to elective abortion. Never. And that has attracted, you know, we're still in business after 28 years, and it's very hard because you have to pray for us, and we have to pray for you, because there are centers growing across the country, but the pressures against them are unbelievable. So I would recommend to your audience, pray for healthcare providers, physicians, and all the rest every day, so that that power of loving the patient but hating the disease, and knowing that medicine is an act of mercy, that's what's going to stand up to the hatred and to the bitterness and to the pain of trying to be the best patient you can be, the best mom you can be.
And Dr. John, very briefly before we finish, I did just want to speak about how your work is becoming harder. You know, with the midterm elections coming up, the fact that Roe versus Wade has been overturned is really intensifying debate on both sides. How have you seen that translate to your work at the Tepeyac Center?
So at the Tepeyac Center, they are still doing what they always do. I've had to move on to be president of Divine Mercy Care. So what's happening is we have an opportunity right now to say the word abortion, because the other side doesn't want to say it. We can say the word abortion, and we can reclaim so much of medicine right now. So Divine Mercy Care is not only raising alms for Tepeyac's care of the underserved, but we're also teaching medical students and residents and colleges and college students and other doctors who are just burned out and disappointed in what medicine has become. So this idea of medicine as an act of mercy, it's about teaching, assisting, and accompanying people, whether they're patients or providers, through this challenging time, and maybe help them see there's a better way.
Well, thank you so much for the work that you do. It's so needed. We're so glad to have you here, and congratulations on your new book, Dr. John Bruchalski.
Oh, Prudence, thank you so much.
God bless you.
God bless you.